I'd been for a walk in the morning and it was springtime. And I remember seeing daffodils. I remember seeing the daffodils and observing them and thinking about how they would grow differently in different places each year.
I wanna take you somewhere, so you know I care, but it's so cold and I don't know where. I brought you daffodils on a pretty string, but they won't flower like they did last spring.
So this piano, I was, my granddad bought me in 2002. Around, I think I was 11 or 10 or 11, 12 maybe. And when I went to record Another Love for the first time, I tried all these pianos all over London where we were recording the album, and I could never get the tone. So I ended up sending a white van to go come pick it up. And we transported it to London. And so this was the piano that was on Another Love. And as soon as I play it, it sounds just like the song. But... it's a little out of tune now. Yeah. This riff, it was what I had first. I guess I was still only 19. I think it existed in my head for a while and it would be something I would play on the piano.
And I wanna kiss you, make you feel all right. I'm just so tired to share my nights. I wanna cry and I wanna love, but all my tears have been used.
The song began to take shape. My mum found these lyrics, which are the original lyrics, and the chorus was on another heart, all my tears have been used up. So it wasn't called Another Love, it was called Another Heart.
On another love, another love. All my tears be used all on another love.
It's ultimately a kind of desire to be happy and to move on, but being stuck in the past.
Another love, all my tears be used all.
Choir, which is all me. It's got these layered backing vocals. I think they're probably inspired by the Beach Boys and Fleet Foxes. It haunts you. It's certainly become a hit, and the thing that I remember a lot, you know, when I was speaking to my manager, was that no one wanted to play it on the radio, because it kind of wasn't a ballad and it wasn't an upbeat song. It sort of fell somewhere in between the two. It started as a ballad and then it became an upbeat song. So radio were very reluctant to ever play it, and so that was always a problem. Curiously, it wasn't really till in the past couple of years that it's, you know, really found its audience, and I'm so grateful for that, yeah.
On another love. Another love, all my tears have been used up.
That was the first festival I ever did. That was one of the first times that I noticed people were, that knew the word.
Another love, all my tears have been used up.
And then it very much became a song that was being used by Ukrainians in those first few weeks to make videos on social media about not so much the war, but how beautiful Ukraine was. When I visited Kyiv in 2019, it was one of those places that was, it felt like it was growing, you know, exponentially. It was full of young people starting businesses and record shops. And I was like, you know, Kyiv is a fucking cool place. And so it was very shocking when that invasion happened and you saw those images of, you know, bomb rockets being fired on Kyiv. And then I started seeing on top of that, my song being used, you know, by Ukrainians as they made videos showing how much they loved their country.
On another love, another love. All my tears have been used up.
I think after seeing lots of those videos that where it's being used for incredibly delicate but admirable, you know, actually tragic but also kind of awe-inspiring, you know, humans doing incredibly brave things in the face of such terror, I think it makes you hear the song in a different way. And I think what it made me hear is defiance, and it made me hear more hope than perhaps I'd heard in it before.